My name is Dr. Elizabeth Boyle, and I'm here at Folgers Marsh on the island of Nantucket, and we're in the high marsh zone. This is a zone that's only flooded by saltwater, extremely high tides, just occasionally a couple times per month. And what we find in this zone is a species called Spartina patens, which is this thinner grass that we see here. There's a little mixture of the Spartina alterniflora that we mentioned before from the low marsh, but it's mostly Spartina patens where I'm standing. And that's called salt marsh hay. As we move a little bit this way, we find another species of grass, this higher grass. This is a sedge. Sometimes you find a rush called juncus, but this is a sedge with the little flowers on it. We also see here evidence of animal activity in this high marsh. You see a path right here. That's not from people, that's from deer. So deer will use the marsh to feed. There's a lot of insect activity here. Again, more terrestrial organisms rather than the mussels and the fiddler crabs that we found down the low marsh. There's also a special snail that lives in salt marshes called this coffee bean snail. And this snail will live on stalks of Spartina patens. And it is actually a pulmonate snail, meaning it has lungs. It does not obtain oxygen through gills. But it does need the water to reproduce. So to avoid, it will climb up the stalks when the tide does flood this area. It will climb up the stalks of grass so it doesn't drown. But it will release its eggs into the water, and the eggs then develop out in the salty waters of the marsh creeks, and some may even move into the bay.